back to my channel. I'm in my new apartment, so that means I can start, you know, making videos more often. I, you know, don't have such a shitty backdrop. You know, I got, you know, trying to go for some sort of, you know, studio set. But I got kind of a different video than my first video that I made featuring myself. I'm not going to be reviewing an album today. Instead, I'm going to be doing a top 10 MGMT songs. MGMT has been one of my favorite bands for a while now. They're definitely in my top five. And I can honestly thank them for being kind of my transition into, you know, more psychedelic and more out there kind of songs, because I felt like before then, songs like that might have been kind of off-putting to me. But I mean, I fell in love with MGMT, and they're now one of my favorite bands. So this is just my opinion, and I'd love to hear what you guys think are your favorite songs by MGMT. Let me know what you guys think about my opinions, but of course, you know, don't get too pissed, because my opinions. So number 10 on my list comes from the album Congratulations by MGMT, which you'll be seeing quite a few songs from this album on this list, as it is just a work of art, and it's working as a fantastic album intro song. I feel like it, you know, introduces you to kind of the beachy, surfy sound that the album kind of has throughout. And it's just a really high energy, high paced song to start the album, and it bangs. So I would say that's definitely number 10 on my list. Number 9 on my list comes from their most recent album, which is Little Dark Age. And this is kind of an out there pick. I don't know how many people are going to have this on their top 10, but Days That Got Away is phenomenal. I guess I mentioned on Reddit one time that's one of my favorite instrumental songs, but I guess technically it's not, because they do say Days That Got Away, you know, a few times in the song. But most of it is just like kind of a, not really ambient, you know, it's just kind of moody, and I really like how, you know, kind of dark it is, and it's one of my favorite of their, you know, more, not really depressing, but it's just kind of got that mood of, you know, like they described their third album, it's kind of like melted ice cream. I don't know, I guess that makes sense, but it's just a really cool kind of interlude in the album. I feel like a lot of people is probably the one they skip the most in the album, but I really enjoy it, and it's my number 9. Going back to Congratulations for number 8 is Flash Delirium, which for a while, this was my favorite MGMT song. It's, you know, again, another one of those really like kind of trippy songs. And the lyrics are really weird but awesome, you know, like singing about how hot dogs are getting cold, and just the outro is phenomenal. How it, you know, it just all comes together at the very end, and it ends with a bang. It just ends really suddenly, and it's a fantastic song that fits in this album. Number 7 on my list comes from MGMT's self-titled album, and it is An Orphan of Fortune, which is the album closer for their self-titled album. And again, just a really dreary song that you can just vibe to. And my favorite lyric in the song is, you know, if I never feel right, or if I don't ever feel right, you know, polishing off the sand. Just his vocals in the song are just fantastic. Andrew does a great job, and you know, it's a fantastic song, and it really is a kick-ass ending to, you know, an album that is pretty dreary all throughout. And it's a fantastic ending. And I just like how, you know, slow it is, and it perfectly encapsulates this album, and it's my number 7 pick. Going back to Congratulations once again for number 6 is Lady Dada's Nightmare, which is a song that, I don't know, I guess I just took forever to listen to, and I remember someone on Reddit posting like a meme about it, and I was like, I'm gonna go check out that song. And it's extremely creepy, it's dark, and it's perfect for this time of year as we head into October. It's very, you know, like I said earlier, it's dreary. The instrumentals are just, you know, it's very kind of creepy, but I love it. And I love how there's like a first half of the song that's kind of setting up for it, and then when the screaming part comes like halfway through the song and it just picks up, I get chills when I listen to this song, and it's fantastic, and it's my number 6 pick. Number 5 on my list comes from Little Dark Age, and it is When You're Small. When You're Small is another one of those songs that has a really kind of like a cool build up all throughout. I love the lyrics by Andrew in this song. Again, it's kind of just weird, but I really enjoy it, and it's one of my favorite songs from this album. And that, you know, the last part when, you know, everything comes together, and, you know, singing when you're small, you know, it's just really weird, basic lyrics. It's classic MGMT, and it works great for this. Number 4 and number 3 on my list both come from MGMT's self-titled record, and number 4 on my list is called Plenty of Girls in the Sea, which is probably the most upbeat song in this entire album. Every other song is pretty, you know, dark, and this one I feel like is the only song that has a really upbeat, you know, kind of positive feeling for it, but it still really works in this album. It's kind of like a sea shanty is kind of, you know, the feeling I get from it. It's another one where the lyrics are very abstract and just, you know, kind of random and weird, but actually I take that back. They're not random. They are just, you know, abstract and great. And it's like melted ice cream, dude. It's the very end of it where there's the backing vocals where they're singing like plenty of girls. You know, it's just, it's a great chorus. And I really am in love with this song, and it's one of my favorites by them. And number 3, again, it's from self-titled. It is Alien Days, which is the album intro. And honestly, this is one of those songs that just took a few times to click with me. And when it does, it is just absolutely fantastic. I love the intro at the beginning where they, I think they got a kid to, you know, narrate the beginning part. And then Andrew comes in with his vocals. And just, these are some of the best lyrics in any MGMT song, in my opinion. You know, my favorite is, those days taught me everything I know, when to catch a feeling and when to let it go, or how to catch a feeling and when to let it go, something like that. It every time I listen to it, I just get chills. It's just perfectly sung. The instruments in the background are fantastic. And again, it really sets the tone for one of their more decisive albums. But I think everyone can agree that Alien Days is kick-ass. We're getting near the end of my list with number 2, and that comes from Little Dark Age, and it is Time Spent Looking at My Phone, or TSLAMP, which is one of their most catchy songs. And if you're one, like, if, I mean, and no hate, if you enjoy Oracular Spectacular's big 3 singles, no hate, they're fantastic songs, and I don't believe in gatekeeping anyone. But if you are one of those people that love those songs and you kind of need a catchy MGMT song to kind of transition you into their other stuff, I'd say Time Spent Looking at My Phone is great. The hook is very addicting. It gets stuck in my head. I love it's kind of basic. The entire song kind of has the do, 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 all pretty much all the way throughout. But I really enjoy the ending where it's do, 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 do. Yeah. Anyway, I really just enjoy the ending of Time Spent Looking at My Phone, and it's my go-to MGMT song if I'm just looking for a quick, you know, MGMT song to just jam out to, and I always enjoy it when it comes on. All right, number 1 on my list should probably not be a surprise to most people, but number 1 comes from Congratulations, and it is Siberian Breaks, which is one of the greatest songs I've ever heard in my life. I feel like most MGMT fans can appreciate its greatness, but if you've never heard it, it's 12 minutes long. It's essentially like 6 songs in one. My favorite stretch of the song is about halfway through. If you look at my channel, I just posted a video the other day about Siberian Breaks, and my favorite part is about like 6 minutes in. It just, you know, it slows back down. It's extremely psychedelic. It's, you know, trippy. And the lyrics, it's poetry, you know, it's just, I cannot rave about this song enough. It deserves to be number 1, and it's probably going to be one of my favorite songs till I die. It's just great. So that wraps up my MGMT countdown. Comment below some more ideas. What are some other bands you want me to, you know, tackle or make videos like this? I'm probably going to be making my LW review in a few days, so my King Gizzard fans out there, you guys can look forward to that. Spoiler alert, it's going to be a pretty positive review. I really enjoyed that album. But that's pretty much it. Give me some constructive criticism in the comments. I'm trying to get better at this. And yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. Not really the best way to end a video, but